Every time I think there's just no way the British government can possibly get any worse, any lower, any more despicable, the British government replies, "Hold my tea." The New York Times reports, "Rejecting asylum claim, UK quotes Bible to say Christianity is not peaceful." London. Britain's immigration department has been condemned for citing violent Bible passages as the basis to reject an asylum claim by an Iranian national who said he had converted to Christianity because it was a peaceful religion. The Home Office, which is responsible for handling immigration, security, and law and order, used verses from the books of Leviticus, Exodus, and Revelation in an attempt to argue that Christianity was hardly peaceful. The asylum seeker's application was denied on Tuesday, according to the man's legal representative, who shared details on social media. So, an Iranian Muslim converted to Christianity because, unlike Islam, Christianity is peaceful. The British Home Office basically said, "You're a liar, because Christianity is a religion of violence. Here are passages from Exodus, Leviticus, and Revelations to prove it." Now, those of you who know anything about the Bible should already see a problem. Exodus and Leviticus were written about 14 centuries before Christianity. They're about what's called the Old Covenant, a covenant between God and the children of Israel. This covenant was connected to a piece of land and involved judgment on certain nations for sins like child sacrifice. The New Covenant is a covenant between Jesus Christ and Christians. This covenant isn't connected to any piece of land, and it has nothing to do with Christians going out and punishing anyone for their sins. So, if you claim, as the British Home Office claims, that Christianity is violent because of commands that aren't directed at Christians, you immediately expose yourself as a total moron. The other passages were from Revelations, which is about the end times, wars, persecution of Christians, and God's judgment on the world. What in the name of common sense does God's future judgment on the world have to do with Christians being commanded to commit violence? Think about what the British Home Office did here. In the Bible, there are teachings from covenants that predate Christianity, and there are teachings of Christianity, and there are prophecies about the future. Instead of going to the teachings of Christianity to see if Christianity is a religion of peace, the British Home Office goes to teachings that predate Christianity and aren't directed at Christians, and to prophecies about God's future judgment, and then completely ignores the commands that are actually directed towards Christians. What are the commands that are directed towards Christians? Love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. Love your neighbor as yourself. Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Never pay back evil for evil to anyone. If possible, so far as it depends on you, be at peace with all men. If your enemy is hungry, feed him. And if he is thirsty, give him a drink. Let all that you do be done in love. Walk in love. Pursue peace with all men. Honor all people. Is it possible for a Muslim to look at these commands and conclude that Christianity is peaceful? According to the British Home Office, no. Anyone who says that the Bible's commands to love everyone and to pursue peace with all men have anything to do with Christianity being peaceful must be a liar, and his plea for asylum must be rejected. The case drew a rebuke from the Church of England, and immigration advocates denounced the decision as another example of the Home Office's harsh methods. The man, who has not been identified and had converted from Islam, filed the claim in 2016. The immigration caseworker and legal representative Nathan Stevens wrote on Twitter, "It was not clear whether the man had made his conversion a basis for his claim." But the Home Office used extensive quotes from the Bible, such as, "You will pursue your enemies, and they will fall by the sword before you," from Leviticus, as evidence against the asylum seeker's claim about Christianity. These examples are inconsistent with your claim that you converted to Christianity after discovering it is a peaceful religion as opposed to Islam, which contains violence, rage, and revenge, read a rejection letter Mr. Stevens shared excerpts from online. So again, the British Home Office basically called this man a liar for claiming that he converted to Christianity after realizing that Christianity is peaceful while Islam is not. Now, we've seen what the Bible commands. What does the Quran command? O you who believe, do not take the Jews and the Christians for friends. They are friends of each other. And whoever amongst you takes them for a friend, then surely he is one of them. Fight those who believe not in Allah nor the last day, nor hold that forbidden which hath been forbidden by Allah and his messenger, nor acknowledge the religion of truth from among the people of the book until they pay the jizya with willing submission and feel themselves subdued. Surely Allah has bought of the believers their persons and their property for this, that they shall have the garden. They fight in Allah's way, so they slay and are slain. O you who believe, fight those of the unbelievers who are near to you, and let them find in you hardness. Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, and those who are with him are severe against disbelievers and merciful among themselves. Is it possible for a Muslim living in the Middle East, looking around at the endless misery and bloodshed that have been caused by Muhammad's teachings, to say, you know, I don't really believe that this comes from God. I believe that God would tell us to love each other. But that's what the Bible says. Could someone come to that conclusion? Absolutely. In fact, for those of us who interact with Muslims regularly, this is one of the most common stories we hear from converts. But the British Home Office says, nope, it's impossible. No one could seriously compare the Quran and the Bible and see a difference in what they teach about peace and violence. The immigration caseworker said he was stunned by the contents of the letter. I've seen a lot over the years, but even I was genuinely shocked to read this unbelievably offensive diatribe being used to justify a refusal of asylum, Mr. Stevens wrote on Twitter. As outrage grew on social media, the Home Office distanced itself from the decision, though it confirmed the letter was authentic. This letter is not in accordance with our policy approach to claims based on religious persecution, including conversions to a particular faith, a spokesman for the department said in an emailed statement. Asylum cases based on religious persecution and involving religious conversion require a great deal of expertise to assess, said Colin Yao, a lawyer specializing in immigration at Garden Court Chambers. So, asylum cases based on religious persecution and religious conversion require a great deal of expertise to assess. That's why the British Home Office assigns total morons who think they're Bible scholars to assess these cases. Keep in mind, we only found out about this because people picked it up on social media. If there hadn't been public outrage, the British Home Office would be sending other asylum seekers the same message, because, again, one of the most common things we hear from ex-Muslims who are now Christians is that the hatred and violence of Muhammad led them to the love and peace of Jesus. With this in mind, I say to the British government, on behalf of all Americans, I'm glad we dumped your disgusting tea into Boston Harbor. Your tea sucks, and basically so do you. Americans now drink coffee to show our contempt for the British government. Every cup of coffee we drink is a symbolic slap in your pompous faces. I've never agreed with the French on anything, but I agree with everything the Frenchman said in Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
You don't frighten us, English pig dogs! Go and boil your bottom, sons of a silly person! I'll blow my nose at you, so-called Arthur King, you and all your silly English kniggets!
Speaking of Monty Python, I wholeheartedly approve of John Cleese fleeing Great Britain due to its corrupt and cowardly leaders and journalists. It's now clear that his comments about you in the Holy Grail were more heartfelt and sincere than anyone at the time realized. I hope that some mad scientist opens Churchill's grave, gets some of his DNA, and grows a Churchill clone, just so I can watch him give one last epic speech about how you pathetic losers are leading your people to destruction. I'd be happy to keep going, but the Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Sniveling Cowards just sent me a restraining order. So, for now, cheerio.
Now go away or I shall taunt you a second time!